Today we're going to be talking about brand overhauls. So very often we have companies that come to our website and their immediate, the thing that they put in their inquiry is this: we're going through a brand overhaul, or we need a brand overhaul. So like, basically, how do we do that? Like, how do we get started? We'd like to chat with you or get more information. Some people say the actual needs that they have, requirements. This may come in the form of through our website. Someone put in a general inquiry. We're receiving an RFP. It may be a referral. Someone sent the referral and say, hey, I work for company X. We're going through a brand overhaul. We love your help. So there's different ways that people approach us, but I'm going to narrow down exactly how you, as the marketing director, as the director of marketing, digital marketer, whatever it may be, when your company is going through a brand overhaul and you're spearheading this thing, you're the one that's interviewing agencies, you're the one that's gathering information, I'm gonna give you really good, three good steps to be able to take that'll help you throughout the process. This actually just came out in Forbes. We may be filming this a little early, but this came out in Forbes on January the 9th. And so I did a whole article about this, and we'll put the link so you can check that out as well. But the first thing that we'll go over is you have to figure out your approach and don't skip the pre-planning. So what I'm talking about, don't skip the pre-planning. What I really mean by that is that you want to go to, if you have the accessibility, you want to go to shareholders or stakeholders. You want to go to anyone that's going to be a decision maker throughout the process. Now, this varies from different companies. Majority of the corporate companies, there's different teams. There's a social media team. There's a marketing team, whatever it may be. And you're just the director, and you're basically putting all these things together and bringing everyone together. You want to be very specific with what's going to take place in a direction that you want to go, that you're gonna go, excuse me, the direction you're gonna go. So what I mean by that is that you don't want to just go to them and say, hey, we're going through a brand overhaul. We're gonna get our website completely redesigned. It's gonna look like X, Y, or we want it to look like X, Y, and Z. Give us input. Don't be general, be specific. So say for instance, it's a social media team or the social media department, and you're saying, hey, we're gonna go through a brand overhaul. What are some of the things that you all are doing intentionally right now on social media so that when I gather this information and put it out to vendors or put it on RFP, then we can make sure that it complements, or we can make sure that we collaborate effectively so that everything comes together. So you want to be specific with each department so that you're not being general and then you just have all of these different opinions and everyone's just saying what their opinion is, and it's not based on the overall goal. Yes, the overall goal is that you want a brand overhaul, meaning you need a, rather be a new look, an enhanced look. There's a lot of corporate companies and Fortune companies that we work with, and believe it or not, they haven't had their website updated in like 5, 7, 10 years, it's kind of understandable, right? If business is going really well and you're not looking at it from the digital standpoint, but maybe one, that digital standpoint is starting to affect your business, or you have to do branding for employer branding. I talked about that on a previous show before with GoDaddy, and there was kind of an extreme analogy, but when you have employer branding, it means that maybe you're targeting millennials, people that are fresh out of college, et cetera, and they're gonna do their due diligence and they're gonna go online, they're gonna look into your company, they're gonna go look at your LinkedIn page, they're gonna go look at your website, of course, and they wanna be part of a company that's modern, that's evolving. So whatever your scenario may be, you wanna make sure that to each department or just the team collectively, however your company is formed, everyone understands and knows the overall goal. Like, we're getting a brand overhaul, but this is the goal. And then you want to go through during the pre-planning as well with your IT team, if you have one, or IT consultant. You want to make sure you have all the requirements together. And this predominantly goes with RFPs. On RFPs, when it comes to that, you want to be very, very specific. Hey, we want to have this type of security. We have to make sure that we have this type of functionality. It can be integrated with this. We want it developed out on PHP. We want it to be PHP. We want it to be on WordPress, Drupal, et cetera, et cetera. Hope you don't go with Drupal, but regardless of which one it is, you want to make sure you have some of those specifics down if necessary. Some people have other specifics and they are more like, hey, we want to know the best platform that's going to be for us, for our company as we scale and as we grow. So when it comes to pre-planning, you want to make sure you speak with decision makers. You want to make sure that the ultimate decision makers are on board. You don't have to give them all the details. Most of the time, they don't want all the details. They just know that they need something better. But you want to get an understanding from them of at least initially what they're looking for. Gather that information. Any departments or the team that you have, you want to get everyone's opinions based on a specific goal and their specific role. And then at that point is when you want to distribute and send this out to however you do amongst vendors and agencies to basically put a bid in or put in a proposal. Now, that was number one. Step number two, speak with any vendors that you send this RFP out to or that you contact for this specific project. The reason you want to do that is because you have to think about the relationship. When you're having an agency, someone or company outside of your company that's going to come in and they have to basically assess and break down not just your goal, but they got to understand the company, your service, or your product, and what you do in some form of way so that they can actually deliver what this vision you have in your mind and bring it to life. Now, throughout that process, there's a lot of questions. It's going to be the step number three. But staying on point number two, when you speak with these vendors, the main reason and the why that you want to do it is to build a relationship. One thing about our company, our entity, ATX Web Designs, when someone sends an inquiry, if we're interested in actually putting in a proposal or potentially interested in it, what we do is we got to hop on a phone call. You send over an inquiry, you have information, whether you ask to hop on a call or not, whether you say we need this ASAP, whether we're going through the process of it and we're going to be doing 4 months later, let's hop on a phone call. For us, we need to make sure, one, that it's going to be a project that we feel we should even put a proposal in for, meaning maybe the scope of what you're asking for doesn't really meet your budget. Maybe you're kind of just like, you have way too much going on. It's going to be too difficult for us to come in and bring things together, which we've had that before. What I mean by that is that the company didn't do their step number one, their pre-planning. So when they got involved with us, there were so many other things that they needed to do on their end that it made the project go 9-10 months versus 4 or 5 months. So you don't want to run into those type of issues that can cost you a lot more money in the end as well. But building a relationship, whoever the person is that you're speaking with, the person is just going to be going through this process, making sure that he or she, you can connect well with them. Because for the next 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9 months, however long it may be, for that time period, you're going to have, like, you're going to be in a business relationship with this person and you're going to be talking to him or her very often, or his or her company very often. So you have to make sure that a right fit, not just in regards of the requirements to be able to get these things done, but in regards to, hey, I can collaborate with this person. If you get on a phone call with them and you can tell them in general, not just what you're looking for, but then at the same time, the direction that you all want to go, they should be able to give you feedback, not just yeses and nos, like, yeah, we can do that. Yeah, we can create you an account. Yeah, we can redesign your website. Yeah, we can do your brand. Yeah, we can create graphics for you and do X, Y, and Z. You don't want a yes man or a yes sir. What you want is someone that's going to really pick you apart more and draw more answers out of you by them asking questions and saying, okay, what direction you're going to go? I understand the direction that you want to go. After this, what's going to be the next plan after that? What are you all going to grow into so that as we create your brand, it can scale with your company, right? What's the ultimate goal? Is this mainly for employers that you're trying, or employees that you're trying to hire on and bring on? Is this for to increase sales, to increase leads? Do the shareholders or the stakeholders just want to have a better website? Or is it a combination of all of them? What's the ultimate goal with this? And you want to pick them apart. I love to pick apart the exact goal because a lot of people have these, and we've run across this plenty of times. I would say at least 70% of the time, let me get back to you with that question and I'll get you an answer. Because they may need to go to a stakeholder, a supervisor, or someone in another department to answer that question. And it's good that they do that, just because if you're asking the right questions and they have to go back and ask someone, then it's making them think more and give them an understanding of you need to have these things in place before you move forward. Or if you don't have these things in place, we'll consult with you on how to bring these things together. So that was the second point. Make sure that you speak with vendor. vendors, build those relationships, and get those things done. The third point is asking the right questions. Now, I'm going to go through some of these questions, and basically, these are things that you want to pay attention to. I say ask the right questions, but these are things that you want to pay attention to. Number one, how quickly they reply. What I mean by that is, if you go to an agency or vendor's website and you look at the information, I like their portfolio, I feel like they're going to fit with the stuff that we need, and you put in an inquiry. If they do not reply back to you within 24 hours, that's a red flag. Because they mean that they do not have someone that's dedicated to connecting with the leads that come in from their website, or they're too busy, or they have way too many projects that are going on, or too big of projects. And maybe they don't have any of those, but the whole point is that they don't have a team that's dedicated to connecting with new inquiries that's coming in on a regular basis. So for you, you got to look at it as if you're, you know, you just met someone, right? And you're attracted to that person. Y'all exchange information. You get his or her phone number. You start text messaging. When you first meet someone, if you really like that person, you're going to be quick to reply back with text. Or you'll at least be communicative and be like, hey, I'm at work, or blah, blah, blah. But at the end of the day, at some point, you're going to be quick to reply back, because it's going to be a sign of, like, I'm interested in you. If an agency is not set up to reply back to you quickly and get back to you quickly with whatever questions or their process, then they don't have a streamlined process, and then they more than likely do not have the staff or the people in place to be able to get back to it in a timely manner. So that's definitely a red flag when you talk about how quickly they reply. It sounds like it's not that major. And there's sometimes instances, like for us, for example, this was about 2 years ago. Actually, it was 2 years ago in 2018. Something happened and all of our leads was going to our spam. This never happened, but all of a sudden it started happening. And for like, I would say a month or two, I would say about a month, I was just like, what's going on? I mean, we're ranked really well online. We always get leads in every single week, and we just weren't getting leads in. I'm checking rankings. I'm like, everything is fine. We go and we check spam, and there's like 13 leads in there. And this all happened with, I said a month, it all happened within a span of about 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks. And it was like, oh man. So what I did immediately was, majority of the time, we reply back, we look into the company first, we reply back, let's hop on a phone call. You know, Daniel's available around this time, or you can book a call with this link. Now, some of these were 1-2 weeks, a few of them 3 weeks back. I immediately just picked up the phone and called them. Got in touch with the person that sent in the inquiry and immediately apologized. Hey, usually we reply back within 24 hours. For some reason or another, your email went to spam, but I wanted to call, get an understanding of your project. I don't know if you went through the process right now of looking at proposals, or if you already chose someone, but would love to hear more about it and potentially put in a proposal if it's a right fit for us and for a right fit for you. So that's kind of something that was uncontrollable. It was just one of those instances that happened that we corrected. But even at that, it was like, immediately, I need to call this person. I need to call this company. Let's hop on a phone call. This is what happened, but let me hear about your project and see what we can do for you. Now, the second thing when you're talking about asking the right questions is, how specific are their solutions? We have, like, I have no problem giving solutions at all, even on a proposal, right? I can tell you how to build a house, but that doesn't mean you can actually go build a house. I can give you every single plan, right? I can give you the IKEA plan. If you ever shopped at IKEA and you get all the stuff in and then you try to put it all together, you can give the plan and you can spend a lot of time trying to implement that plan and try to fill the holes, or you can actually just go in and have someone do it. So I have no problem with giving solutions. I've sat on phone calls. Typically, we keep our phone calls short and to the point, but there's sometimes that I'm asking questions, not just technical questions, but company questions that need to be answered. And so with that, when they're answering some of these questions, I'm giving solutions, or I'm narrowing down a solution with the question. And they're like, oh, I didn't think about that. That would actually be really good. That's something that we discussed, but I didn't put it down. So you want to see the solutions that they present. And this is just from a phone call. Before they even put in a proposal, you want to hear solutions. As I go back to my point number two, you don't want a yes man, a yes ma'am, and a yes sir. You want someone that's going to, yeah, we can do that, but let me ask a few questions to make sure that we're going into the right direction. We got the right understanding. So if the person that you're speaking to with that agency is very specific with the solutions to your brand overall, then that's definitely a really good point that you want to hop on top of. And then the third thing is, does their skill fit your specific needs, not your industry? And I say this from a consulting matter, and I also say it from personal too, because we've lost projects because it was like, we loved everything you presented, but this company had more in their portfolio that was in our industry. And what happened is that, this happened a few times as well. We had a company, which is a great client of ours, loved them, I won't say the name, but we had a company that we had proposals in for, sent over an RFP, we did it, we presented everything, they loved us, woohoo. I'm always optimistic, but hey, we won this was in the bag. They didn't go with us. Came down to us and one of the company. We didn't win the project. And I was just like, geez, like I thought everything was great. And I asked him, and the marketing director, he told me, he said, it just came down to that, you know, they chose this company because they had more in their portfolio that was our specific industry. And I was like, completely understand. I would understand why they would make that decision. If y'all need anything in the future, if there's anything you need, do not hesitate to let me know. I definitely hope that y'all's project go amazingly well, etc. This is genuine because I really want these companies, especially we speak to marketing directors. So I say a company, but these are companies that may be grossing, you know, 9, 10, 11 figures, but the marketing director has the most pressure, or that small marketing team has the most pressure, because they're the ones that's based on going out and initiating this and making sure that it gets delivered. So I do want things to go very well for them. And it was great. I had a great relationship with them, even with the presentation. The marketing director even told me he was going to refer our company, our agency, to others that he know, just like other companies that he know, because he was very well impressed. He wasn't the ultimate decision maker. He definitely had a hand in who he would like to go with, but he wasn't the ultimate decision maker. So it wasn't on him. Now, fast forward about 3 months later, 4 months later, maybe, but I think about 3 months later, they call or they email me, hey, the project that you put in a proposal for, it's now back open. If y'all are interested in doing it still, contact me. I'd like to discuss the details to where we are right now. Basically, the company that they went with, they went through like this company, our client, went through an acquisition process. It was delay on something. Then they needed the project done within a certain period of time that company was not able to deliver. And so this is why I say, go with a company that has your need, that will fit your needs, not your industry. For us, yes, we have some industry specific companies that we like to work with, but at the end of the day, for us, it's based on need. No, we're not all over the place. We don't just work with anyone. We have some specific industries that we work with often, but say for instance, you're in a medical field. Well, if you're a medical company, maybe you're selling a product or whatever it may be, your problem may be leads and sales. There's another company that you kind of know from the outside looking in what their issues are, but their issues may not be leads and sales. Their issues may be like, hey, we have some people that have stake in the company that are like, our website needs to look better and more presentable because we're going to scale up. We're getting more employees on. We want to make sure that the website is appealing to them to get them on. Everything else is fine. We're fine with leads and sales. It can help that, but we're fine with that. Same industry. Two completely different problems when it comes to brand overhaul. Brand overhaul doesn't specifically have anything to do with your industry. It has to do with the problems that you have internally within your organization, within your company, and these things need to be fixed by this brand overhaul, beginning with your website. So going back to that client, that's a client of ours now, great client. They needed the project done in 5 months. We hit that mark, got it done in 5 months. They kept asking us, are you sure? It's like, yeah. The main thing is that we want to make sure that you have everything in place. So when we send over information, we get stuff back from you. We get information back from you. We built up a relationship. There's always going to be, this is just my last point to summarize it up, but there's always going to be that moment within a project to where things don't necessarily fall off, but you just have to bring things back together, right? The development has begun, you're getting updates, but you're looking for X, Y, and Z, maybe there's slight communication, et cetera. But at the end of the day, which what we tell all of our, before you're even a client of ours, when you're just a lead and we're going through the process, the biggest thing is building a relationship. Because if I have a relationship with you, you have expectations from me, I have expectations from you. Once we build this relationship, and we're going through the process, if there's something that falls off, it's like, hey, I know that they do better than this. There has to be a miscommunication. Let's hop on a phone call or let's meet up. Let's talk. Let's get things back on board. Or there's concerns about X, Y, and Z. A lot of times it's always miscommunication or what have you, but you can get back on board. So as you go through this process, if your company is going through a brand overhaul, thinking about going through a brand overhaul, or in the middle of it, whatever agency it is that you're going through this with, just the top three things is one, I'm gonna go back over them, but one, make sure you pre-plan, get as much information as you can that you can present to the potential vendor. Two, once you contact these vendors, you need to hop on a phone call with them. You need to, not everyone meets in person, but if you can meet in person, do a video call, etc., so that you can build a relationship, get that vibe from that company and from that person that you're speaking with to make sure that they're gonna be a right fit. And then the third thing is making sure that you ask the right questions and that they're providing solutions and that they're asking you the right questions that you can provide answers for or have to go back and get answers for. This is Daniel Griggs, ATX The Brand. Today we talked about brand overhaul. Thanks for joining, and we'll chat with you again next week.